exercise is probably one of the best things a person can do for their brain. By exercise, I don't mean just running on a treadmill. You might, try to balance on one foot every day for, a minute or two. You might challenge yourself balancing on one foot, having the other foot up in the air. That automatically is engaging your cerebellum, is already trying to help you form new synapses to do that function, and those growth factors help maintain the health of neurons. A lot of the late onset dementias are not necessarily Alzheimer's. They're actually vascular disease from either diabetes or hypertension injuries. So being mindful about a healthy diet is just as good for the brain as it is good for the heart. Adults, when they fall and hit their head, it really can be detrimental, particularly older people over 60. Such falls might actually precipitate symptoms of Alzheimer and so on and so forth. And not that it's the fall that made them have Alzheimer, but sometimes you have a genetic vulnerability and you're functioning on limited reserve. All of that now is being compromised due to the trauma. So on top of that, you immediately see an onset. Physical stress, such as trauma, is bad, but also constant mental stress. I'm not saying we have to live a Zen life every minute of our life. That's not going to happen. And in fact, a little bit of stress is a good thing. But it is really that constant, painful stress that could be also compromising. So I think it's that combination, the exercise, the healthy diet, avoiding trauma, avoiding constant stress, all these together, I think would help anybody.